Let's take it to Union Square. Let's take it back to the LQ. Wave your hands like you just don't care. Let's take it back to the old school. Let's take it to Union Square. Let's take it back to the LQ. Wave your hands like you just don't care.
In. The fifth and forgotten element of hip-hop is knowledge. Allow me to share a little with you. A musical art form that helped shape hip-hop is jazz. Jazz is like a first cousin, but it's a little more related than most of y'all realize, because just like its first cousin, it went through similar scrutiny when it was first introduced. It was blamed for the rise in crime in poverty-stricken areas, mostly to do because jazz was mostly performed in the red light district in Louisiana. Jazz musicians battled against each other to see who was the superior musician. But check this out. The New York Times even published an article that was written by a musician warning white people that they should stay away from jazz because it could directly threaten their position in society. I believe he used the word prestige. I'm gonna put the article in here somewhere. Y'all gonna see it right about now. Can you believe that these things were said about jazz? Like, honestly, to tap in real quick, right? Now, that was a little known fact from Street. Remember, hip is the know, hop is the movement. Welcome to Generation X Radio. In the early days of hip hop, everything was about how great the DJ was. The MC's job was to tell the crowd why his DJ is better than everybody else's DJ. As time went on, the MC started to concentrate a little bit more on himself and also getting the party started and being an MC, master of ceremonies, while the break beat was dropping and the break dancers was dancing. The MC was letting everybody know how great he was. But one night, December 1981, changed everything. And this is the scene of the crime. The world-famous Harlem World. Now, I believe everybody in attendance did not know they was going to be witnessing history and a changing of the guard in hip-hop, where the party MC, the one to get the party started, was going to go up against a surefire lyricist and killer. In those days, it was just a rap contest to see who could get the party started. Bomb da bang da bang, Biggie. The party MC went first, Busy B, and he rocked the house. For that time and era, he had the crowd going crazy. Ball with the ball, ba ding ba ding, diggy diggy diggy, sick the boogie to the bang bang. I go ball with the ball, ba ding ba ding, diggy diggy. Come on, come on, come on! Right now, y'all, well, it's time to prepare for the number one rapper of the year. I'm not Dr. J, I'm Reggie Jackson, Busy B is my name. I got all the action. Now y'all heard the rest, and you ready to go with the baddest and MC stereo. I just kick off your shoes and relax your side, cause Busy B's here and I'm ready to rock. And before I go, and before I quit, as I sing and dance a little something like this with the old hip hop box, she rock the rock, stay with me, I'm gonna turn it, hurry up, say ho, come on, ho, ho, somebody scream, come on, scream, now where's that place we work it out, come on, yo, where's that place we work it out, come on, let me say ho, ho, say ho, 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 scream, oh, get on down, get down, get down, that Busy B gotta sign off and let the rest of the MCs in the house, come on and turn it out, just like I did, we got the Cold Fresh Boys coming out, and we got another MC group coming up, the Busy B gonna sign off, see all the people later out there, the place to be, and I'll be back up later, just to point that shit.
it over my head. Y'all pick it on now. All right, now before I go, let me hear y'all say, ho, 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 ho. Now say, la, 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 la. Say it again, go on. La, 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 la. That's it for me, Son of Slam. Okay, on the boys. And all the party people in Manhattan, Boogie Down, Bronx, Queens, Brooklyn. I love you, each and every one of y'all.
See? The party MC did exactly what he was supposed to do, and that's get the crowd involved, hit all the right keys, had them going. But he didn't know. One little thing happened earlier on when somebody said to him, "You ain't better than Mo D," and he said he was better than everybody. Mo D put his name on the list, and history was made.
People, that's the place to be. My name is MC Kool Mo D from the Treacherous Three. My man LA Sunshine in the place to be. We gonna get a little something straight here in the place to be. Don't worry about it, DJ Lee, on the place to be. We gonna get a little something straight in the place to be.
One, two,
my man Busy B Starsky. How many people think Busy B Starsky rocked the house? Yeah. I hear that in the place to be.
Yeah.
But if y'all notice it or not, you know, I heard a lot of shit, you know, Busy B's popping shit, saying he'll take out any MC and all that. I give it to the man, he know how to rock the crowd, but when it come to having rhyme, no way he can fuck around, and I'm gonna prove that right now. One for the treble, two for the bass, Tony D. Lee, and let's rock the crowd. One, two, one, two, doing the do now. Hold on, Busy B, I don't mean to be bold, but put that paw, did it, paw bullshit on hold. We gonna get right down to the nitty grit. Gonna tell you a little something why you ain't shit. It ain't an empty shot that you don't hug. You even bitch your name from the love bug. And not a fight a nigga's name, it's some low-down
shut
shit.
Up, shut up.
If you was money, man, you'd be counterfeit. I gotta give it to you, though you can rock. But everybody know you're on the furious dock. And I remember Busy from the olden times, when my man Tony G used to sell your rhymes. Remember that rhyme called Diddy Bar Diddy? Man, goddamn, that shit was a pity. Too hot to trot, hit to rock a spot. Spoony G rockin' whether you like it or not. He paid for the rhyme, asked for it twice. He said, Spoony G, I'll buy it any price. When Spoony finally sold it, oh, what a relief. Busy B stole it like a fucking thief. Came out rockin', the party's yours. Got everybody thinking that time's yours. Every time I hear it, I throw a fit. Party after party, the same old shit. Record after record, rhyme after rhyme. Always wanna know your zodiac sign. He changed the shit to the favorite jeans. Come on, Busy B, tell me what that means. Hold on, brother man, don't you say nothing. I'm not finished yet, I gotta tell you something. Too hot to trot, I'm hit to rock a spot. I'm gonna rock your ass whether you like it or not. He made it I'll up take a title day. Right on the spot. How can I take a title you ain't got?
That was a historical, monumental, culture-shifting moment in hip-hop. The impact of that moment is still felt till this day through diss tracks and through battle rap. You don't get, you will never get a No Vaseline, a Ether, a Takeover, The Bridge Is Over without that night. KRS-One said it best. Who knows what would have happened within the culture if Busy B, the party MC, beats Kool Mo D that night? Maybe we're stuck in the prehistoric age a little bit longer than we were supposed to be. Bomb did it, bong the bang, ba bang boogie. That's not a knock against Busy B. For his time and his era from the 70s, that's what it was. Mo D changed the face of hip-hop. Battle rap wouldn't exist as we know it. It still would be a rap contest without this particular moment. That historical moment in hip-hop helped shape the future of hip-hop for years to come. MC after MC, generation after generation. Kool Mo D is not celebrated like some of his peers, but his impact is major on the culture and should be celebrated, whether you like him or not, whether you find his glasses funny, or Wild Wild West or whatever is comedic to you. But that night, that moment in history is set in stone, and you don't have some of your favorite rappers or diss tracks or even battle rappers without that moment. Salute to Kool Mo D, and thank you for your contribution to our culture. Because here, we're about preserving the culture. We're about speaking the truth. It's not about being biased, non-biased, unbiased, this bias, that bias, who I like, who I don't like. It is about the truth.